what we're gonna do today is I'm gonna, these mags are beat up. I got a few dollars in each of these mags, and they've seen better days. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and wash these guys off and clean them up, and we're gonna actually use stencils to paint some designs on these guys. And we're going to go through the process of how to use stencils and how to kind of paint different layers. I know I was always kind of confused about it, but I've been wanting to do this for a while. So I'm going to go ahead and take these mags apart and get them cleaned up. And then we'll get into the supplies that I need. Okay, these are the supplies that I have. I have two coats of paint. One coat will be the base coat. One coat will be like the top coat. Depending on the type of stencil that we use, I'll show you how I paint either type. Because there's going to be... I'm going to use these note cards to create the stencil, so I'm going to draw on here, draw on the note card, and then cut it out with the X-Acto knife right here. Then the X-Acto knife was actually the most expensive thing. It was $3.90. Got some clear coat. You know, I don't expect these to last too long, but the clear should help them last a little longer. And I actually have a flat clear, and I have a flat black. And I have a gloss red, so the red will pop a little bit. At least that's the plan. I have two-sided tape. I'm going to use the two-sided tape to actually stick the stencil to the paint. We'll see if it tears it up or not. So I'm going to go ahead and get to drawing while my magazine bodies are drying out. See, I've disassembled them and degreased the outsides. Well, I'm not exactly the best artist. You know, I've drawn Superman for a few years, but I don't know. It might be good enough to cut the stencil out. I just don't really... It'd be a multi-piece stencil, and I have to tape those little tiny pieces in there, and I don't have the steadiest hand. I mean, this X-Acto knife's kind of rough. So what I did was I butchered one of my Gears of War 2 instruction manual, and I cut out the Crimson Omen, and I actually traced it onto this. Yeah, they're kind of rough, but by the time you spray paint them, they'll probably look very similar by the time I cut this thing out. So that way I can have two. I can have one for each side. That way I don't have to peel it off and do it. I can do one magazine at a time. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this guy out, and I'll have two, roughly similar stencils, and then we'll get to spraying the paint. Well, for better or for worse, here are my two stencils. So, you know, they're not exactly perfect, but, you know, I mean, it's the best I could do in short notice. So I'm going to go get a magazine, and let's see where we're going to space these guys. Here's a clean and dried magazine. So I'm thinking somewhere low, like maybe like that. You know, see how it kind of takes up that. That's almost a perfect size for that magazine. You know, because if you, well, it's upside down because there's a magwell or there's the magazine catch. But I'm gonna use the double-sided tape to stick it on. But first we have to spray a coat of red. We're gonna paint the red because I want the emblem to be red. We're gonna paint this guy red, and then we're gonna stick the emblem on, and then we're gonna paint black over the top of it, and that way, when I peel the emblem off, it will the red underneath will come out. So that's the plan, anyway. Now, what I'm gonna use to hang these guys on is this metal hanger that I've unwound. They're real convenient. You can actually just hang it on the hanger, but this is my harebrained scheme. Because it allows you to hang the magazine on it, and then you put the hanger back together. You get a nice little hanger rack there. So I'm going to go ahead and hang two of these guys on here because I want to get at least two magazines. And then I'll take these guys outside and we'll spray them. There's the two magazines on a hanger. So I'm gonna wind this hook back up. We'll take it outside.
Of course.
Always gotta be blowing the direction of the camera, don't you? Anyway, this is the gist of
what I'm doing.
And of course they hit the ground. Go figure. Well, here's my four works of art. Should be enough to at least let me do two mags. And, you know, they're not exactly the same, but I'm not that picky. So, hopefully we'll get something that actually looks decent from at least 20 feet away. So I'm actually waiting for the red paint to dry, and I'm gonna go ahead and tape these on the side and go paint them black. Okay, I've got my decals stuck on with double-sided tape, and they're not on very strong. The only thing I'm really worried about is maybe the wind blowing them off, but I'm gonna go out there and spray the black on while the red is still tacky. That way the black will grab harder. And I'm not really going for perfect either. I just kind of want to get the image there. So I'm gonna go see how it goes. I hope they don't blow off in the wind. That's the only thing I'm worried about. Let's see if I can spray this without having the paint go all over the camera. I actually have gloss red and flat black. Do nice light coats. So I'm just gonna do this, get everything kind of coated the way I want. I might even leave the edges maybe a little red, you know, so that they're not completely covered, just to kind of give it that red kind of a you know burst or whatever. So far, I like them. See how you kind of got the little red bursts along the edges? Got that nice flat clear coat. That'll look real nice on them. I might do one more shot outside. I spun these around so that they can be in the sunlight equally, but see how there's a little bit of red? There's a lot more red frost on that one. I think that's cool. So, you know, it's not perfect. It's just right. I'm pretty excited to see how these look. From what I can see on the edges, they look okay, you know, but I guess we'll find out. I'm a little worried that the mouths might not come through, but, you know, it's not exactly a Rembrandt. Actually, I think they turned out pretty good. You know, you can see a little bit of white from where the paper kind of stuck to the paint. I really don't think I could do much about that without tearing up the actual finish, but, you know, for $11, pretty happy. They look pretty good. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that flat clear coat. Temperature's on the low side, but it still is within the can specs, so I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bit of clear coat while I got my light left. Well, they're still tacky, but I'm so excited because they actually turned out pretty well. Like, you know, the one side is all black, so, and then the other side has, like, you know, just a little bit of red. I didn't spray it completely. So that black looks pretty cool, and that would be the side that's on the right-hand side. And here's the other one. Still tacky. See how it's just got a little bit of fade red? You know, for $11 worth of material, I don't have any problems. See, the mouth kind of didn't come through on that one, but that's okay. That one actually looks really good. No complaints. No complaints at all. It's only got one coat of clear. I might do a couple more once it dries and it's not tacky. But it looks pretty righteous. Here's the other mag I didn't clean up. I didn't want to make two more stencils. Looks like this is kind of caught the hanger there. But that's alright. Not too worried about that. I'll have an idea. I'll be right back. It's pretty righteous, man. Can't say that's not awesome. So, there you go. There's your Gears of War magazine right there. I don't think there's any way I can really avoid it scraping off. Especially if I actually intend to use these magazines, but, you know, still doesn't look too bad.